know what it is? It's because of where the hard camp is that you pull with that nice little like buffer hole above and on the radiant side. But like when you're playing radiant offlane, it just like it's harder for them to actually mess with you.
Okay. I see what you mean a little bit there. Yeah, I would also say that like once you're past that first laning stage and like either the tower is down or if you're in my case, you're just cutting waves, pulling the waves to the other camps. There's like two very easy camps to pull the creeps to and then farming up both of them. It's the Tundra special there. So let's see what ends up happening here. Oh, interesting. So for the longest time for IG, I don't remember if I saw this last time or not. It might have been the thing. Emo had been the main drafter. Zhang Yu is drafting right now. And I'm unsure if that is indicative of something. If he picks a brewmaster, we'll know.
Yeah, then we know. Or if the coach just won a different seat. Maybe this one was closest to the AC. One nice breeze. Who is coaching for IG these days? No.
Oh, it's a little S super. The one and only.
Little S?
Little S.
Lil S Super. I feel like when I first started watching Dota, Lil S Super was the more famous super, and then over time, I feel like Big S Super became more famous.
Really?
Or maybe Big
I thought
S
it was the
was
other
just,
way.
You know, maybe Big S was just bigger the whole time.
Yeah, I think he was bigger, and then he became less important in the play aspect, but his like name sort of still held some weight, and then it's like switched back around again. All right.
Pretty iconic though overall.
They take it away from him.
Still on the super thing. Big S was way more viewable, though. He was, I mean, the guy, if you're a newer Dota fan, Big S Super, we call him Little S Super and Big S Super because one's tag was super with a small S, lowercase. And the other super was with a big S, you know, capital S.
Yeah.
And he basically only played DK and Viper, and it was very funny. And that was it. That was it. I don't know. It doesn't sound that funny, I guess, but trust me, it was really funny.
And then the thing was that he expanded his pool like a little bit. And he added like Death Prophet, which is basically the same thing. And like, it was like, all right, well, and I remember being at Perfect World Masters and Kyle was still playing for Complexity and their team was like on the verge of like getting into DPC points and like making it far. And he was like up late the night before. He's like, I just don't know what to do. Should I just ban all three of them? I don't know. And then he like didn't ban one of them and then Super just picked Death Prophet and then they lost and were eliminated and Kaio was like shit and then they played against Vici and Vici just banned all three of Big S Super's heroes and they immediately lost like it was like a 15 minute game and they got 2-0'd and that was like the grand finals or 3-0'd
Kyle's just there with tears could have been me
it was you know Limp and Hand Skinner off to the side like dude why didn't you the hell anyways of that to say that they have taken away Collapse's Batrider.
That's right, they've stolen it. Could be support, could be core. We'll have some options here. For now, Team Spirit, they want another Laurel Ember game and they have Mirana, a fantastic combo. If you have a friend who plays mid and you play position 4 or position 5, you can pick Mirana these days and feel really comfortable about it, because once the lanes break down, you just run around the map, you slight, you chain, you throw arrow, they die. It's great. So Mirana is not as grief of a hero as she used to be, as long as you wait for the stuns before you throw your arrows. That's the only way you're allowed to play the hero, guys. Except for when you're really feeling it, like, and you know you're going to hit it, then it's cool.
Right.
But you only get like two misses.
I will say I love Mirana. This is it's just a feel good hero in general, you know?
Like Windranger, right?
Is that a feel-good hero?
No.
I have a pretty decent win rate on Mirana, too. I love this hero. 66% over 94 games. Hell yeah. Sorry, I just looked at that.
66 over 99 games.
Yeah.
That's pretty good.
Killing it.
Wow.
Paired together with the Ember, how do you like against the Terrorblade, though?
I only have 58% over 84 games.
Get owned. Get owned.
I have a 70% Omni-Knight win rate over 41 games.
Oh, okay. That's impressive.
Goat.
Well, right. Did you think they're gonna pick Omni Knight again on IG? They did it before.
You know what? They might. They just might. You know, okay. Dust goes mid. Emo plays TV. Brings out his Omni. They liked it versus the Ember. Do you think he's been playing the Earthshaker? I've noticed some mid players have been practicing Earthshaker in pubs.
Really?
Ever since some of the... Who was it that played it at Dream League and they owned? I can't remember who it was. Was it Laurel? Someone had a really good... No, it was Beppu. It was GBK, I think. Okay.
Jipika.
Sounds right. Maybe it was Nine Pandas and I'm crazy. But either way, someone picked Shaker versus Ember, which used to be a classic counterpick, and they did really well, and it was great.
You know what I was just thinking about?
What was that?
There's a lot of players where we say, like, the letters out, you know? GPK, QYQX, PYW. What if we just phonetically say them instead?
Pew.
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 Pew. Pew.
That would be the best one for sure. Pick Sniper as the right cosmetic. That could be good.
Pew. Fun. Gipik.
It was so Kiyotaka. Darkseer. That's who it was. Sorry, it was Kiyotaka. He picked it twice versus Embers. Nice. They won both games. So, kind of hype. And so did Sumail. He lost both games, though.
All right. So, maybe the Emo will not be picking. But there's a chance. They ban out a lot of very annoying heroes. Darkseer, PL, and Naga Siren all taken out of the pool for IG.
It's a GPK. Anyway. Yeah, solid bans, and they are covering the flex. I like that, because like you said, his pool is very small for Zhang Yu. So yeah. The Mars and the Brew are his two best. They could just ban the Visage, honestly, because the Visage didn't do well, but we discussed why. They went all in on the lane, and it worked. There's a chance that doesn't work, and you get really sad. And instead, they just ban the DK. It's kind of interesting. Ban DK. I mean, it is a very stable hero with Terrorblade. I will say that. They play around similar timings. He's a nice force to have when you want to approach towers with meta. He's very stable to play with.
I think some people think of it as like kind of a light counter to Ember 2 in lane, where you can really mess with the CSing with Dragon Tail 2.
Yeah, you don't want to slow down your game. Saying whatever hero you want to pick for that offlane. I'm going to make sure they don't have a good time. Undying's still in the pool, by the way. Kind of crazy, but Undying also versus Ember, Mirana, Lich looks pretty bad, so not expecting it here.
Okay. Yeah, let's just pick three cores at the start. It could be a PYW Batrider, actually. I think it actually might be.
It doesn't have to be. I think the Bat is fine right now. They banned a lot of anti-bat, like they already banned the PL and the Naga, right? So then they would have to go Slark on Team Spirit versus the TV and the Storm. Actually, it looks kind of okay.
I think that having that flexibility to swap it up, I would anticipate that they're going to like have that prepared because... And like go for like some super duper counter pick, because I think that's just the way that IG drafts.
Ooh. I was actually going to suggest Disruptor. I think Disruptor would have been an insanely good pick here, because it's good versus Ember and if they went for a Slark pick on the earlier end.
Right.
But Silencer is a little bit easier to execute, obviously. You just global and hopefully kill the Ember. Ember does not really like buying Dispel these days, right? You don't really want to buy a Yules. It feels quite bad on the hero. Mirana can rush Lotus, though, which I imagine she will.
And some people will do, like, the Manta thing or whatever, too. That could be an option for him.
Yeah, Manta's solid. Just takes longer. Right? Get that, like, quick one.
Yeah. Ooh. Okay.
There's been rumors about that this hero's broken.
Really? What are the rumors? Yeah,
I don't know. People seem to think he's broken. I saw Clairvoyance was doing some tweeting. He had some really great threads, actually, if you're interested in terms of the current meta and what teams that he's been looking at as a coach, the C region. I thought it was pretty interesting. He seems to think Tide is mega broken. I think Tide is good as long as you have a very active mid laner and active supports, which I see right now with the Ember and the Mirana. To me, this looks fine. I would like a carry that's also somewhat active, too, because Tide is just so static. Gets the Meteor Hammer, chills in the lane. But picking the Tide does mean they don't get Slark, as expected.
Okay. 10 seconds remaining. That one
Find
taken
a,
away.
A different carry.
5 seconds. I mean, well, you know, this Yadaro guy, I think he does really struggle to have a carry pool, you know?
Yeah.
Something I've heard about him.
He doesn't know too many heroes, you know? Him and Zhang Yu, similar issues.
Yeah, he's like, I see you, brother.
What am I going to do?
All right. RIG, do you think with what we've seen so far, there is any incentive to switch the Batrider to a support, or are we just getting what we're seeing three cores out of the gate?
I'm trying to think of what position one would really make this game hard for him. That's like, there's not many position ones that are good versus Bat and also good versus Terrorblade, right? Terrorblade wins most of those matchups. But I guess if the Batrider's game is so ruined anyway, then it doesn't matter.
Can I flip it on its head? Is there an offlaner that you think does better this game than Batrider?
That's what I'm trying to think too. Because like, you're getting counterpicked anyway, and a lot of the hardcore counterpick carries are all in except for the ones that are good versus bad, right? But if you think of, like, the melee heroes, then like the Ursas are still in, the Monkey King is still in, so you could run into problems there. The big hero that sticks out to me is Underlord is still in. He looks relatively okay in this situation. But again, then you run into the Monkey King or the Ursa issue, and I think Ursa would be really good for you.
Yeah. And I think they would pick it too.
Yeah, I think they
would.
That
Lich is very scary playing with it. But they do ban out the Doom, so that at least was in the back of their head as something that could happen in a minute 41 seconds for IG to take their pick.
Does he play like Viper? Sorry, not Viper. I meant to say Venno. Pool's so small. So. I mean, the only hero that's left in his pool is like Visage.
Yeah.
That he plays regularly.
I think that they're leaving that one open for him. But again, it's probably just going to be another support that they take here. You could take a Caudle. I think Caudle fits like pretty well in terms of enabling all of this. Maybe the lane is a little bit rough.
I think they need something beefier, though. Then they have like nothing that sticks into a fight, you know? I feel like the Spirit Breaker and the Doom were good because of that. Like, who's just getting in there for your team right now? Give
like
me some
emo
vision.
Storm.
The Storm get in. Yeah, exactly.
Ooh, Clockwork?
Fox not bad, because in most laning situations, you can salvage it with cogs.
Yeah.
But, you know, I almost said it, because I was thinking, you know who's getting in there? Could be Omni. All right, so this is probably... support, right? This is still, or I guess this is core for, what are we doing here?
I am not sure.
Is this a PYW Omni?
I think it's support bat and they're running three Omni.
Yeah, I think so too.
Or, yeah, I think that's what's happening.
I guess we're going to find out. Because I feel like you want a core Omni right now. I don't think Omni feels that great. Oh god, they left in the animage. Because now you have no pressure on the safe laner. Well, I guess Omni's actually kind of okay.
Yeah. Interesting.
It does pure, right? The hammer?
Yes. I think.
So that's pretty sick versus animage. You like that. But we discussed this in the last draft. If there's one thing that Yadro likes to force, it's anti-mage. I was so focused on the Terrorblade matchup, I didn't even consider the thoughts of just like, how are you going to mess up this Storm Spirit? I don't know if they thought that or if they just felt like Anti-Mage won't have a good time versus Omni Knight. That's also a possibility because Omni Knight Bat looks like a pretty oppressive dual lane. Lich, though, again, one of the best heroes in these situations for trying to secure yourself a good time. So 10 seconds. This is looking interesting.
Trent, can I tell you something?
Please.
There have only been 48 heroes not picked after day number one, and after the first series of day number two.
Nice.
This is Omni Knight's second game. And the other thing was Meepo was picked in just the last set of games. Execration took it and lost with it. So we're we're getting through a lot of the heroes so far at this major. It's pretty exciting.
I'm very much looking forward to this Omni Knight. I'm not really sure exactly what his benefits will be in this game. Curious. Let's see what the Omni Knight gamers are up to right now. look at the toppest of the pubs. It's mostly just Echo Saber builds. Look, I mean, you ready? Obviously. Okay, I'm ready. What? The hammer. You're throwing the hammer. I see that.
No, it's harpoon.
That is good.
Oh, it's harpoon.
Sorry, I thought you were doing the hammer. Well, I mean, when one gets the echo, it's... That is the main thing, right? That is the dream with this hero right now.
I'm a big fan of that. I didn't mean to throw you off your hammer there.
No, I was actually enjoying looking at the intros for some of the players because they showed like Mira had collapsed stickered onto his hero stuff. It's very nice.
Oh, okay, I like that. I have myself stickered onto one of mine. Is that narcissistic? Is that a problem?
I have you stickered on my Darkseer.
I have me stickered on my Darkseer too. Oh, let's go. You're never going to play that, though.
It felt necessary. I love Darkseer. I have a great Darkseer win rate. Yeah. I used to play him all the time. He was one of my most played offlaners when I first started playing Dota.
Nice.
I played 123 games and I have a 61% win rate.
That's really good.
Gonna say.
Oh, battle. No battle. Not battle yet.
Not a battle.
No, we want battles, but we're not getting them. So... Interesting dynamics to watch. Omni Knight, can he be big, bad, and burly and strong? Can he carry this game? Does he need to? Also, where are they going to get stuns? Because right now I see two of them on the team total, and one of them's an ultimate. And the anti-mage, I think, likes that.
Yeah. A lack of stuns. Just, now you know. Yeah, that is an issue. That's a big issue. We need a lot of pure damage here from Zheng Yu. So we assume that his big thing that he needs is the echo, and then you want to hit that shard timing, right? Because the shard's pretty crazy with the echo and then into the harpoon. That is the goal.
Right. Uh-oh. Zheng Yu?
Oh! He juked right into it.
That's not good. Oh, no. Maposhka draws the first blood. Wow. And he's going to TP back to that lane because they're sending Dust down bottom to play in this lane as the Terrorblade.
And Yadro has
now,
also gone top.
Oh, they swapped it. Oh, that's annoying for IG.
Well, this is what IG want, I think, right? They want to play the Omni into the Animage, I assume.
I think they tried to dodge the Omni Knight away from the Anti-Mage. Pretty sure.
I think this is what they want. I think they want the TB free farming.
Okay. All right.
That would be my assumption, at least.
I feel like Collapse might be able to do something here. Maybe not, though. Maybe they are doing this.
Because this seems pretty solid. So, things that I like would be... Tide and Mirana. I think this is a great lane duo. You can do Gush into Arrow fairly consistently. It's not as free as a lot of other things, but it's fine. Oh, ooh, Mira thought about chucking that arrow out there, but wasn't going to connect onto Dust. Is Mira going to the tree lines and shoot a YOLO arrow? That's the question.
I'd love to see
now.
It.
Yeah, for now, not happening. Seven last hits for Zheng Yu. He's pulling the waves apart. He's getting the hits. This is working out so far. Level 2 could be tough, though.
You want to see throwing those hammers down right away. Obviously, AM going to have easier access to the secret shop to get into that cornucopia or the ring of health, depending on which way he wants to go with it.
Yeah, and this comes back to what I was discussing in the draft of being the radiant side and how much better it feels is sending your carry here. It just feels like an option that you have that Dire... It's just not as nice. It's harder to pull as the Dire size you're going to see down bottom. It's been blocked off by Mira. It feels harder to deward this camp, too. It's a real pain.
Arrow?
Watch the arrow.
Not quite going to connect there. Still, Dust is taking a bit of a beating. Interesting.
Now the question is up top now. What happens when Omni's out of mana? He doesn't have a stick yet. He's now going to send one out. He's like, right, should have brought that maybe. So I can actually have a chance at turning the damage. Because they are keeping this camp open. So if Maposhka is able to get this spawn and control this will be excellent for them. I'm wondering if QYQX will run over here and just throw a sentry down, though. I think you really don't want this spawning.
Yeah. Collapse dies in the meantime down bottom. They're able to run him down. But QIQX does manage to get the block off. Okay.
Oh, and he got him. He's going to get it.
Oh, my God. Mira, not where he wants to be. PYW. Ooh. As stick charges, Mira should be fine. Surely Mira's fine.
Where is he going to go?
Goodbye. That was a long TP.
Yeah, I think if he had committed to that, there was a chance. I guess he has no sticky. I thought he was being stickied and stuff. I came in halfway through. I was watching the support battle at top.
Lots of battles everywhere.
But he's only level 2 on bet. Because he's a support.
Fair, fair. Well, 3.5 minutes in. And so far, mid very even. AM and Omni farming quite well. It's mainly just the Terra Blades who are running into trouble as Emo tries to get away. Blood Grenade down. Laurel is right there. Emo going to get killed as Mira jumps past PYW. Now, he still has stick charges and fairy fire. Mira trying to bait this out as long as possible and just walks away.
Yeah.
My God.
PYW hoping that he would be forced to burn it, but it doesn't happen. Mira wants to arrow something here before he goes home. Come back mid and do a bottle refill. Or maybe he's going to stick around instead of arrowing a creep.
Oops. Uh-oh.
Accidental double tap. Classic.
Double tap. PC dead. Uh-oh.
Dead.
Damn. Like that one bit.
No. Jiangyu's lane is going great. 23-2 on the Omni, considering they counterpicked the Animage, brought it in here. Things have gone swimmingly, I would say. YQX is getting a pull-off.
Has the full Soul Ring coming out on Omni Knight, which is a little bit interesting. I'm wondering how he's sort of going to deal with the mana cost there, because AM's probably going to keep clicking him. It's not a place that you love to be.
That's true, but Animage also only has 600 HP, and he has 6 armor, but you're doing pure damage. And in combination with the Silencer, who also does a lot of damage and does pure damage, it's if he commits, there is a danger.
Okay.
Oh, a 13-second blink cooldown.
Ready to go. Team Spirit back on line, ready for action. So
why is Anti-Mage's base blink 13.5 seconds?
Leaps, arrow, connection, Emo. Oh, that is as his CP came out and QYQX, he's in. Laurel with the double kill. Even if he dies here, I think he is perfectly fine with this. And honestly, he might not die. Laurel gets another one. Oh my God. He's happy to die at that point.
Yeah, they both just died to the creeps on purpose. They intentionally did that. Because there's no point trying to survive, right? Like, because sure, you'll give up the goal, but you don't give up any XP, and you're going to be back around the same time that they return. I can't believe they just kept completing the TPs. But then when PYW did, I was like, all right, here's the cleanup. But again, he's still level 2.
Yeah. Lowest level in the game. Yadaro now onto Zhongyu. Tried to Soul Ring. It's not going to work the way he wanted it to. It's just not.
That is a consequence of what just happened mid, right? That is why that just happened. They're able to jump on him because they know the Silencer can't come back top.
God, they're scanning Emo.
Buddy, dude. buddy, click Emo.
Oh, he's ready.
No, Emo, no. Is it going to happen? Is it real? Is he listening? Emo?
He knows what he needs. I told you, he buys this item. He does this.
I thought you were joking.
Emo. And he also gets his freaking bounty. Oh my God, no, Emo. All right, we might be seeing those magic words from Emo again that we saw in last game. Because cannot be pleased right now. Oh, jeez.
He's mentally checked out. He's going back to the safe lane after this one. And Dust taking mid next game.
Arrow. Ooh, PYW able to dodge it. I think it matters, though. Laurel's level 6. They're on him. PYQX might be dead, too. We're 6.5 minutes in, Trent, and it is looking bleak. Oh my god, it's a 4,000 gold lead at 6 minutes. Emo wants it. He's not even level 6 yet. You just make him walk back home again. It's not fair. Oh, jeez.
I do like how he denied that creep in Laurel's face. That was good.
That was good. He's like, give me a bottle refill. Oh, damn it. Moshka's going to steal it. They know. Oh god.
Alright, look at Yadaro up top though. He's doing some math right now. You know, he's like, I got my treads, okay. This Omni Knight, if I jump on him right now. Meanwhile, the bounce back to Mapochka.
Ravage safe. Out for the turn. Has Sinister Gaze. Can drop it on a PYW if they need, but they also have the Moonlight Shadow. The walk away. PYW, he's in trouble. Does he go down to Collapse? The Gush is there, and Anchor Smash for the finish. Collapse gets the kill. Wow. Well, Emo has finally hit level 6, working on that Midas.
He needs this 8-minute rune, but I don't think he's in a position, unless it spawns bottom, but even then, he has a remnant, so yeah, he's not going to rune. Oh, tough times. He tries to go top, but Mira was there covering anyway. And of course, it's an arcane rune here for Laurel. So maybe someday he'll get a rune. He's gotten one power rune in the last two games. Got as Storm Spirit.
Earns the punch. Tries to get the kill as QYQX goes down to Mira.
Oh,
jump in, blink in. Emo, the retribution. Oh, it happened. Listen, when Emo goes to the safe lane, good things happen. What a TP by him.
I can't believe Yadro was still within striking range of that. Mapochka comes in. Not level 6. Does not have a glorious play here to make on a low mana storm. Very high level, though. Mapochka almost at level 6 right now. Thanks to stealing that Wisdom Rune, of course. Collapse doing Tidehunter things. Gets a Meteor Hammer on the whole wave and the tower. This is the dream. The Anchor Smash level 3 as well, reducing a crazy amount of damage onto Dust. Anchor Smash, though, famously does not do bonus damage. It is just your base damage, unlike the Dragon Breath. So, still really good versus TB, but not when he goes meta.
Yeah. Should keep in mind as well that right now, IG, I think, have three cores that are just going to basically do nothing for a very long period of time in this game. Because Emo is just about to commit to finishing that Midas as PYW getting ran down by Laurel and going to be a dead Bat Rider.
Can't believe he's actually going to great. I feel like I've manifested this.
It's an Emo thing. Oh, he's not going to kill these creeps. Dude, oh my god, he's going to commit to
They're a little too tough.
Your hammer.
Is Emo going to die? Emo?
No.
No.
Can pull it. Emo.
He doesn't even get the stack? All right, Emo's tilted.
he just wants it so badly. And there's the Midas. He's like, guys, come refill my bottle. Come on.
Yeah, I don't have time to go home. They're like, you're right there, man. No time. Oh, Mamochka. He just let the ulti rip.
It. Drops it down. Zhang Yu in trouble. Yadaro has mana void. Thinking about it. Doesn't even want to use it. Okay, he used it.
Feeling a little tough there. Where's Collapse going? He doesn't even care. Yeah, I'll go over the secret shot. It's fine. Maybe he should have cared, though.
Thunder. Ravage. Walk away. Collapse. Does he go down? There's a chance.
Oh, no, his Midas. Oh, no, don't die, Emo. Your Midas.
Laurel. They
get the catapult.
Oh, he didn't get it.
He got the creep. He got a creep before he died.
Okay,
it's all right.
Did. Thank goodness. He also was able to get that kill on Collapse, which is pretty huge. You know, the comeback train, it's starting to get the choo-choo going.
I'm of the mind that you should be able to Midas enemy heroes if they're at 50 HP or less.
Ooh. Arrow. Flight. Needs it. Gets it.
And you should get the double XP too. That'd be busted. Okay. Oh, that'd be such a good comeback mechanic, actually. Ice Rock.
Midas seen heroes.
Yeah, they have to be like, it's 50 cool. I feel like 50 is fine. Like the odds of getting 50, if you have to like really nail it.
It's like
broken item versus dazzle. You're just they get graved. Like,
It's like how in Pokemon you had to weaken the enemy before you caught it with a Pokeball. That's like,
yeah, exactly.
How Midas's works.
Yeah. And if you do it to someone, they die. You get all the benefits, but they stay as a golden statue till they respawn.
Like this arrow, yeah. Not gonna connect, but dust. No more sunder. They're not going for it. Laura, a bit of restraint is the TP.
Oh, this has been a fun one, guys. I gotta say, we're only on the second game of the night here, and sure, things don't look good for IG. Maybe they have like a 10% chance to win this game, but the Dota's good. Look at the steal of these stacks, though. Oh my goodness.
They did such a good job of shutting down emo. The habitat?
Yeah, you know, like this is just like eco side. You know, that's just a happy ecological disaster there.
Hmm.
Right? Like those creatures living in harmony. Yeah, exactly. Tide is oil spilling all over them.
I think, yeah, that's fair.
It's vengeance.
As a watermelon man.
Yeah, you know, he's seen what happened, you know? He's not a fan of BP, not a sponsor. No sponsors here are committing oil spills in the ocean.
There it is. Yeah. Sotomro is going to chase down dust on that note. Finding an opportunity. Poor old dust. Ooh, reflection though, that's actually pretty good against the AM. But I don't think it's gonna matter. I'm pretty sure Dust is dead now. Arrow connects. And Yadaro gonna take the kill.
Alright, but plus side, QIQX, almost level 6.
True. Big. True. Huge. And big.
Big if true, perhaps, one could say.
Oh my god, they're gonna steal their rune again. Collapse is there.
Collapse, don't. Come on, that's not fair.
Yeah. Yeah.
Don't follow the little white line. He's going back.
Wait.
He's going to ravage for it. I think he ravages. He's going to do it.
Oh my god. Wait, what? Okay, yeah, he's just going to walk over and take it.
Back. Let's go.
PYW, what a god. Dude, if Tide doesn't walk over right there, I think he gets it for free. Oh no. Oh, the chain frost. Jung, you almost dead. Still managed to survive. Laurel does go down to dust, and Mira also in some trouble. None of this had to happen, Trent.
This is all Class's fault.
Collapse, what are you doing? All right, little Yadaro's coming to clean up. Okay, maybe Collapse cleans up. They still have Sunder.
I love how instead of fighting, he went for the rune. Like, instead of playing with Laurel, he's like, I want that wizard rune though, bud.
Yeah, it's true. A funny duck.
Minus 103 damage, by the way. Anchor smash, gross.
PYW, no. What? Going from a Poshka? Emo, making the kills happen. It's been a rough game, but he knows what he needs to do to catch back up.
Midas.
Yes.
I am surprised he's top of his team. The fact that he's only 1,000 behind Ember is pretty impressive.
Things happen.
Omni is close to Echo, so that's pretty good. Big upgrade.
And of course, you talked about it earlier, the shard, if he can get that done in time. Of course, it is an 8,000 gold lead, and there really is not an answer in this game for Anti-Mage.
No, there's not. And they're going to be progressing with an Aegis soon, I would guess, from Team Spirit. They can kind of go get it whenever they want. Collapse is going pipe because Mira wants to go mech on the Mirana, like we discussed previously. Nice build-up. They're going to Moonlight. I was going to see Dang you up here.
Find. They can get him. And...
what do they want?
Ooh, hello, Dust. How are you? Arrow for the follow-up. Sunder comes out. They are on Maposhka, who chain frosts both. Oh, my God. Almost gets him brought down for death. And in fact, with the chase forward, Lich dead for Terra Blade, but the root now on to Emo. And, well, everybody on IG is dead except for Bat.
They're
GG. Emo's had enough. That is a classic there. 16 minutes. My God.
Yeah, this one was over pretty fast. Once the Midas comes out on the Storm Spirit, Hulk's kind of lost here. Let's be honest here. And Team Spirit